In all honesty, for me, I was fascinated by the television as a child. I was fascinated by the weather as a child. So I get to incorporate both. There are a lot of meteorologists who are off camera, behind the scenes, studying models and things like that. And I love doing that as well. But for me, it's actually the combination of the two. I enjoy being on TV as well as enjoying the science of it. Now, not just necessarily being on TV, but actually taking the science and making it easy for somebody at home to understand. I think it's a very complex science. It's very fun for me to share the knowledge that I've learned within meteorology and why thunderstorms develop, you know, what that means for you during your day, and just basically taking a complex science and making it simple for somebody at home to understand and to get paid for. You know, it's a fun job. I believe the science is very important. I think if you look across the board as far as news and broadcasting, as news, sports, and weather, the one thing that impacts everybody is the weather. If it's raining outside, everybody's going to get wet if you go outdoors. You may not necessarily, and it doesn't mean it's less important to that person that, you know, sports is not important at all or news is not, because it's not the truth. I mean, they are important in their own right, but I think the one that covers all is weather, and therefore meteorology, and therefore the science. It's very important. But to be out here and to be the expert, quote unquote, the expert on it, I mean, if you're on TV talking about it, you're going to be given that title. The science, the background, the knowledge, well, you have to have that, otherwise you'd be lying to the viewer and things like that. And again, we don't come out here and talk about mesoscale convective complex. It's not what we do. We look at them on the radar, but we say, hey, it's raining outside, we've got some thunderstorms there. The science of it is absolutely important. And again, just making it easy for somebody at home to understand is the overall importance and how it's going to impact their day. And like I mentioned, I'm concerned with some sports scores. My kids are in school and things like that, but only on every other day or so. But every single day I'm concerned with the weather. If there's a fire at some house or some structure or a crime rate in some part of the city, that may not be the part of the city where I'm at. The rain will typically cover everybody. The snow will impact everybody. If you've got 10 inches of snow coming in, that could cripple the entire city as opposed to a basketball game. And I hate to say that because I'm a big sports fan, but I think out of the three, I think there is an importance of the three, and I got lucky enough to choose this field. I think, again, it's of the utmost importance. And the National Weather Service, their slogan is essentially their motto is to save lives. And with the advancement of Doppler radar just over the past 20 years and the advancements of computer technology with that technology of radars to be more streamlined and basically quicker, we can give more lead time for warnings. It saves lives, and essentially that's what it comes down to. You know, flooding, it impacts people. People are put out of their homes. The flood of 2008 in the Wabash Valley with the Wabash River, which it didn't come out of its banks. It was just around this area. People were waking up and water was coming in their homes. And so to get that information out and to broadcast to them, we were the only outlet for them to get that. Everything's on computers. Everything's mobile now as well as the television. Just getting it instantly, it's an instant world, unfortunately, for everything. And if we can't get it instantly, then we're not doing our job. But with severe weather, I mean, if it impacts your life, if it's a tornado, if it's a flood, if it's a hurricane, and you don't know right then, well, you're going to find out one way or the other, and it may be the wrong way. Balance the need for ratings and true science. I basically just try to be honest with the viewer. You know, I don't want to do too much. I don't want to be a gimmick and try to get a viewer to watch me because I am a gimmick, because I'm not giving them the truth. I want to give them the science. I want to give them the truth. I want to give them what's going to impact their day and therefore earn their trust. And I think by doing that, then they will watch, they will trust me, they will know me. And then you got to be accurate too. I mean, we're not going to be 100% right every day, but you just have to do the best you can. So that's how I get the viewer, is by being myself, being honest with them, and earning their trust over time, and it happens. But I think the other thing, to go the other side and to be a gimmick and things like that, it works for a little while. You can catch somebody off guard and they'll watch for that. But definitely, the long run, they're going to read through and know exactly what you're about. I really think the important thing is to stay humble. In this business, you're on TV, you're automatically going to get respect from people as far as, and I said earlier, being called the expert within the field. But just staying humble, stay grounded, because again, the viewer will see through that over time. And again, just being yourself, just nose to the grind, do your work, and don't expect to be the 24-hour weather leader unless you really are. You know, be there, do the job, cover the weather, and not necessarily don't have a life outside of it, because that's not true. You have to find that balance within your own personal life. But, you know, be there for the viewer and be there during times of severe weather, be there times of clear weather as well. And again, it's for me, I love the science of it, so I don't mind being there all the time. Now, with kids and being married and things like that, yeah, of course it is different. But somebody coming right out right away, I think the biggest part of creating a foundation for your rest of your career is nose to the grind, hard work right away.